Hello, everybody. This is Aurathas, and welcome to the first of two brand new Let's Plays that will be showing up on the channel. This one being Conan Exiles, and the other one will be Shadow Tactics that will be paired with Conan Exiles, meaning that Conan Exiles and Shadow Tactics will be posted on the same day, and Rimworld and Sanctus Reach will be posted on the same day. And they'll just alternate back and forth like that, just so you guys know that the other series are still going. This will just be, like I said, alternating with them. Now, with Conan Exiles, I also want to put out a few caveats or notes or whatever about this playthrough. One, expect it to be pretty damn bloody, violent, gory, whatever. Just be prepared for a more mature gaming experience, just because if this is anything like Age of Conan the MMO or the source material, the original books, it's going to be extremely damn brutal. So just keep that in mind, and you know, language from the characters. I know I swear a lot in my commentary, but bear in mind that the characters in the game likely will as well. So yeah, and the other thing to keep in mind is this is an early access game. I am playing this game for the first time as I'm recording this. This is the first time I've ever played this game, and it's about 20-30 minutes after the game was officially launched, and it's an early access launch. So yeah, expect to see some optimization issues, expect to see missing content, expect to see the game not run very well. For all I know, it will run great. I hope it does. But, you know, don't judge the game too harshly if it doesn't. I mean, it is an early access game and has only been in early access at this point for, you know, 20, 30 minutes. So, you know, give them time, give them a chance. And, yeah. So, let's get right into this and see how it goes. Oh, also, I am playing on my own private server, just playing a single player game. I may open it up to co-op to get some friends in here with me, or, you know, I may go on to just a public multiplayer server. But I'm gonna save that until I know. I'll make that decision when I actually know how to play the game a bit more and know what the hell I'm doing. I don't want to dive into a multiplayer server and basically get my ass slaughtered over and over and over again while I'm just trying to learn how to do something basic like fucking feed myself. So, there is that. And if you guys want to see a multiplayer playthrough or let's play of this game, yeah, feel free to let me know in the comments below, and I'll take that into account when I'm making my final decision later on after I've figured out how to play the game. Alright, let's get to the character creation. Male. That's interesting. We're gonna create our character after they've been crucified. Gotcha. Race. Is this the slider up here? Okay. Let's look at them. Hyborians encompass those descendants of the barbaric worshippers of Bori, who swept from the north millennia age ago and destroyed the ancient empire of Acheron. The original Hyborians were tawny-haired and gray-eyed, but intermingling with other races has diversified their appearance. Okay. Sumerian, barbaric and warlike. The Sumerians are the descendants of the ancient Atlanteans. They fight on foot mainly and make savage raids on their neighbors to the east, north, and south. Now, I'm not 100% certain on the lore, but I'm pretty sure Conan is a Sumerian. And I really should be better at the lore. I mean, I really enjoyed playing Age of Conan, and based on what happened with Age of Conan, apparently I was kind of in the minority on that, but hey, I did enjoy it very much. Can't say that I've read the novels, though, but I really want to. Let's see, Stygians are ruled by King Ctesiphon, but it is no secret that the priests of Set are the true power in the land. Only the Black Ring, a cabal of sorcerers led by Thoth Amon, rivals the priests in power and influence, okay? Tribal Himalayan, or Himelian, wedged between the Turanians to the north and the Vendhians to the south. Himelians, I'm gonna have to figure out how to say that, or at least come to a generally accepted pronunciation. Let's go with Himelians. have developed a fierce survivalist society. They are fiercely loyal to one another and quick to turn against their multitude of enemies. Hyrkanian or Turanian, dark and slender, the Hyrkanians are the descendants of the Lemurians, who roamed westward after escaping their slavery in the east by the Kari. The most famous Hyrkanian tribe are the Turanians, who have carved themselves an empire on the shores of the Viliet Sea. Kitan are known to be mysterious and secretive, which increases their reputation as powerful sorcerers. Kushites, very little is known of the Black Kingdoms, but merchants and adventurers report back with tales of both savage tribes and great civilizations thriving among the vast landscape. Nordheimer, the yellow-haired Aesir and red-haired Vanir, are the pale-skinned, blue-eyed race who rule the kingdoms north of Samaria. Known for being wayward and fierce, they use their powerful builds and brute strength to overwhelm their enemies in battle. Sounds cool, but not really my play type. Pict. The tribes of Pictland are continually at war with each other, their neighbors, and anybody who is unfortunate to wander into their territory. The life of the average Pict is one of constant, unrelenting horror, as dark gods and bloody wars threaten to snatch away life and soul at every turn. Jesus, yeah, that doesn't sound pleasant. Shemites. Okay, they're notorious for their skill with bows and their duplicity as traders. The pastoral peoples are considered calmer and more civilized, with highly skilled artisans such as the smiths of Akbatana. Darfari. So barbarians, savage bandits, murderers, blah blah blah, form loose bands in order to bring sacrifices to altar of their god Yogg. They file their teeth to points and use mud and twigs to style their black hair into horns, giving them a demonic appearance. Jesus. Vendian, referred to as the Golden Kingdom, Vendia has a caste of rulers who are considered close to divinity, in particular the sister of the king, Devi Yasmina, is well known for her Zamorian are reputed to be the best thieves in the world, and cities such as Shadazar the Wicked and the City of Thieves reinforce the reputation of the despotic slate. Zingaran. I actually kind of like them. The Zingaran noblemen are renowned for their chivalry and swordplay, while Zingaran sailors are cursed in seaports around the civilized world as coarse brutes. We're gonna have to do something about that hair, though. That's a little too emo for my taste. Religion. We got that too, huh? We want to go Krom, the god who requires no worship. God of serpents and sacrifice. Set Yogg, god of Kent. No. And Mitra, the god of right and justice. Well, I'm not playing a barbarian. I assume, based on the chivalry and all that, Mitra is probably the god for this guy.
Death is coming.
Okay.
Death is coming.
Death is coming. The gods are watching.
Death is coming. The gods are watching.
Hey!
Cut me down.
Ah!
The gods are watching.
Cut me down. Cut me down, please.
Cut me down, please. Death is coming. The gods are watching.
I think I'll go with that one. That one actually sounds kind of sarcastic. I likes it. Which face do we want? Now, first of all, just to take you seriously, motherfucker, let's change that hair up. Good God. Really? That's not a lot of options. Sure. I look like a character from one of the Yakuza games. Why not? Yeah, that's probably the most... Yeah, it's probably the one I'm most comfortable with. Eyebrows. Really? I'm not sure I care. Okay, I don't want to look like I just shoved my face in a fire and lost the fuckers. Even more like a Yakuza character, huh? Let's go with that. Cosmetics. Eyebrows. Let's go with the dark black as well. Okay. Let's look at the cosmetics here. Eyeshadow. I don't know damn eyeshadow. What the fuck am I gonna pick eyeshadow for? So I don't get any facial hair? This race, I guess, I picked. Which I don't even fucking remember what race I picked. That bitch. Let's see. Yeah, we got the hair thing fixed. Yeah, we'll go with that face. Face details. You know, I'm actually okay with most of this. I don't really usually spend a lot of time creating my character. I really don't see the point in spending a lot of time creating a character that I'm probably never going to see, like, their face, either because of armor or because it's a first-person game. And I really don't like to spend a lot of time trying to create a goofy-ass-looking character, you know, just in case I do have to see the fucker. Height. Mid-size height. Works for me. Physique. Seriously, breast size? Yep, and just so you guys know, because this is going on YouTube and all that shit, no nudity. I turned off nudity on my private server. Endowment. Oh. Really? Oh, good God. If that's what I think it is that basically, if I wanted nudity, that's basically, I can adjust the dude's penis size. Really? The game's gonna give me that option? Okay. Zingaren. Thank you. And yep, I will. Let's just capitalize that. Here hangs Aurathas of the Zingaren. Man, they fucking shoved that shit into my skin. They stabbed those fucking rings into my skin to hang this fucking piece of paper. Fucking ass. Here hangs Aurathas the Zingaren, condemned to death and exile for crimes including disobedience of arrest, inciting a riot, and sullying a virgin. Okay. Any who remove this body, living or dead, from this cross will be flayed alive, along with all members of their family. God damn, dudes. Chill the fuck out. Seems a little extreme. Much I remember, but much I have forgotten. I have been in a far land across misty void. Okay. During the Year of the Cobra, a prisoner captured by unknown means was transported into the exiled lands. Crucified and left to die for crimes that they may or may not have committed, death comes swiftly on black wings. Until fate intervenes.
This land does not love men.
Pretty sure I had subtitles on. We not get subtitles for this?
It might have been kinder to leave you on the cross.
Wondering, is that supposed to be Conan?
We will meet again.
Well, either way, thanks for getting me off the cross. And then apparently leaving me to die. That was loud. Okay. First of all, I'm going to go in here and look at the settings. Make sure I actually left... make sure I actually have subtitles on, because I really... Yeah, we do have subtitles on. Okay. So you can see I turned the music volume all the way down. I'm going to bring the voice volume all the way up in case there is some storyline. I don't know if there will be. And I guess now would be a good time to talk about, for those of you who are not familiar with it, Conan Exiles, really what kind of game it is. Honestly, reading the description, it's kind of a survival game, as you can see in the upper left-hand corner. We gotta worry about water, food, and all that shit. But you can also craft in this game, equipment, weapons, whatever. And apparently, you can also build cities and outposts and recruit NPCs and, you know, go on missions with those guys, summon gods, all kinds of shit. So honestly, it sounds like an open world, survival, crafting, honestly, strategy game. And that honestly sounds really badass to me. Oh, please tell me there's... I did not like whatever the fuck that sound was.
I am beaten, left to rot among the ruins of the past. There are others here, slaves, bandits and cannibals. Exiles from lands I've never heard of. Some of them try to scrape a life from the wasteland, scrabbling in the rocks and sand for their own place. I cannot go on. The life that I left behind haunts me, The sun over the glittering spires of Belverus is forever denied me. The smell of my daughter's hair. I will pass the ghost fence, and this cursed land will finally end me. To whoever reads this note, I leave the last of my water and this message. Stranger, you have my pity. You do not know how cursed you truly are.
Well, that's starting this game off on a pleasant note. I'll take that water. Okay, and fuck whatever the hell is making that noise in the background. That thing needs to back the hell off. I don't know what I'm doing yet. Go fuck yourself. Okay, and just so you guys know, I'm also going to try to keep, especially since I'm going to try to keep my mouth shut whenever we hear any voice stuff like that go through, because clearly, as you guys saw when I go into the settings, I have subtitles. I'll turn those off and turn them back on just in case. I have subtitles on, but they're not showing up for whatever reason. It might be, like I said, game's only been out since, at this point, about 40 minutes, 45 minutes. So there might not, you know, so that might be one of the little buggy things I mentioned earlier to kind of try to overlook. But yeah, so whenever any voice stuff comes on, I'll try not to talk over it so you guys can get what story bits there actually are. Alright. Impaled skeleton. The dry desert winds have mummified this poor wretch. The arrows embedded in his leathery skin cannot be removed without breaking them. So, can I take nothing? I'd like at least that spear. And that's not a fucking... I guess I can punch it. Okay. I guess I can't have that spear. Alright, you know what? Still, come on. Ease up with those noises.
Behold, bonded one, the very boundaries of civilization. Beyond the passage of our highways, lie the wild places of the world, where untamed savages make endless war upon each other. You cannot pass into the endless wastes enslaved. Your bonding prevents it. Return. Follow the road. Any road. All roads lead to the city. Behold, bonded one, the very boundaries of civilization. Beyond the passage of our highways, by the wild places of the world, where untamed savages
make
endless war upon each other. You cannot pass into the endless wastes enslaved. Your bonding prevents it.
Okay.
Return. Follow the road. Any road. All roads lead to the city.
Okay, so we can jump. Looks like the lightning bolt, obviously. Honestly, if I thought about it. The lightning bolt is stamina, water, food. Drop is water. Okay, food, gotcha. Alright. Still no weapons, and I can't tell you how comforted I am in the, you know, my little exploration within a shelter. I need shelter, apparently. Why? Is some bad shit about to go down? Like, seriously, what the fuck's about to happen? Why do I need shelter? I mean, that doesn't look pleasant. Okay. Just run down the hill. Yeesh. That's one fucked up place. We have a floating rock over here. Sure. Okay. Seriously, let me at least pull a spear. A spear not gonna break, right? I'm gonna follow the weird glowy rock thing. I'm gonna follow there and okay. Yeah, like I said, I was gonna follow the big glowy rock thing's instructions to just keep coming this way. The fuck is that thing? Oh, fuck off. Be on your way. Oh, it's a body. Do I get gear now? I'm gonna look at the body first. Come on. I am pressing E to interact.
Gods, curse this sandstorm. We were forced to take refuge before the wind scoured the skin from our faces. There is something in the storm. Beasts. We hear the skittering of their paws outside the ruins, and their howls mingled with the screaming winds. The men are scared. I've put them to work crafting rudimentary weapons and torches from the loose stones and rough plants that dot this place. I've yet to meet a beast that liked fire, or the bite of the axe.
Yeah, no shit they scared. You just said in the middle of a fucking sandstorm you heard beasts scrabbling around. Yeah, I'd be scared too. Is that motherfucker missing his eyes, or if he, or is he, like, just have red eyes? Okay. Well, they just said you can make torches and shit. But I just collected a bunch of shit. So, that's interesting. Apparently, pressing E, you know, to interact also allows me to grab plant fiber and shit. Oh, fuck off, alright? Don't need to be hearing that shit. Let me grab as much of this shit as I can. Equip a tool to harvest. Yeah, you know, if I had a tool. Just saying. Here's my inventory. Recipe, stone pick, fire, okay. Candy branches and rocks. I really hope I don't need 1,001 or 10,001 rocks to make that bitch. Level up. Ooh, gotcha. Learn recipes. Don't I already know all this shit? So I'm guessing the green ones are ones I already know. Apprentice craftsman. Huh. Like, seriously? Can I unlock whatever? Let's unlock apprentice craftsman, I bet. Just to check. Apprentice stonemason? Sure. Okay, so I can craft a stone hatchet for chopping wood, fiber bedroll, and twine. Apprentice stonemason lets me do stone foundations. Okay. Survivalist probably would have been a better move. But hey, we're still learning, so. Okay, and... ah! Let's go with... let's spread this out between strength, agility, and grit. I mean, again, I don't... okay. How easily you metabolize food. Direct effect on armor. Damage you do in melee. Grit. Okay, dude, shut it. Can I just... okay, can I make any weapon? I'm guessing that's food. Okay. Ah, here we go. I am beaten. Okay, so at least I can pull up the note so you guys can read it. I'll just give it a moment. But hey, we listened to that earlier. Okay. What's it take to make... coarse tunic. Let's make a coarse tunic. Let's try not to run around naked all the time. Okay. Did I put on the coarse tunic? No, I did not. Oh, it takes time. Gotcha. Give me more stones. Yeah, you know, I'm not going to advance too far out there while that thing is making that fucking noise. Yeah, I'll try to harvest all this shit later. Give me time to at least equip some shit. I'm not gonna go rushing towards the evil sounding fucking noise. Sealed water skin, let's put these over here. Let's use. Okay. And I'm guessing the handful of insects is food. Am I right on that? And I am now out of water, okay. I barely get any food from grubs. Well, let's eat all of that shit. And, can I make this yet? Yes, let's make the gloves. Make the shoes? We can make the shoes, okay. Do we you want to pick? No. I'd like a weapon. But it does not look like I get my say in that. Let's craft one of these. Okay, and while we're waiting on that, let's just collect a bunch of shit from around here. No? Okay. I do not like whatever the fuck it, what the fuck is moving? Nothing. It's okay, it looked like that whatever one of those fucking things that was, you know, stabbed and set up on the fucking... Yeah. Can I harvest from, like, any stone? No? Is it only... Oh, okay. Yeah, never mind. I'm doing damage to this thing for no reason. I think I'm doing damage to this thing for no reason. Okay, so it's a very specific rock that I can harvest from. Good to know. Okay. Alright, so we're just gonna continue picking up stone. I'm just gonna hang on to this just in plain view. You know, anything comes up on me, I will shove a pickaxe through its fucking forehead. I mean, it seems like the way to go, right? Can I collect normally once I've got this thing out? Or do I have to put my tool away to gather? Nope, I don't. That's good. Well, it said to follow the roads and kind of ran out of road. Okay. That was a pretty abrupt change. Huh. It seems sheltered in here from sandstorms, but... How much you guys want to bet? Yeah, look at those fucking statues. How much you want to bet this area is infinitely more dangerous than what I just walked out? Okay, yeah, there's a something. There's quite a few somethings. Yeah, we're gonna collect some more shit just in case those fuckers over there want to fight. We have a tribe of something over there. The fuck? There's a lot of shit going on. And I don't trust any of it. Okay. Let's... Oh. Is this one of the harvestable stones? It is. Holy shit, look at that. Okay, what the fuck? Oh, okay, it just fell apart. Gotcha. And then I can pick up the pieces. I like that. I'm gonna collect some stone here real quick. And if I could get some wood. Come on. Do I not get more plant fiber out of it? Okay, over here is plant fiber. Okay, I need a tool to harvest that. Yeah, I don't want to go after those guys until I at least have something armor-like. I mean, I'm not even wearing fucking pants, for the love of God. Can I make one of these, too? Excellent, I want one of those. I still don't know how to make a weapon. Weapon seems like it'd be a useful... Huh, I should probably also... Let's see, I have plenty of branches. I have 25. I need twine. I need 3 twine. Okay. Thought I had more plant. Yeah, I have enough plant fiber to do that a couple times. Let's go with survival. And we need a better carrying capacity, but I guess I can't do that yet. Learn recipes. Okay. Where are the recipes for killing shit? Stone sword. Ooh. Campfire seems like a good idea. But I need weapons. I don't trust the shit in this game. I need twine. Okay. Why can I not craft more twine? Oh, okay. I used up all my plant fiber. Didn't think I did, but yeah. I guess it makes sense. The plant fiber technically stays in my inventory. I would prefer if the plant fiber went away as soon as I told my people, my dude, to build something or, you know, use the plant fiber. But, what are you going to do? I'm sure these are things they'll work on. But still. Okay. What the fuck is... I need more plant fiber. Give me more plant fiber. Do I have to... Nope. Okay. You would think plant fiber would be all over the inside of this place. Yeah, let's get some wood if we can. Oh, wood and branches. That's useful. Legitimately, that's... Okay, that's just going to disintegrate. Okay. Let's get a bit more. Not sure what I'm going to use it for yet, but it's helpful for now. Alright. Yeah, we're going to just take a measured approach through this area, because I don't know what's going to try to fucking kill me and what's friendly. Well, this is Conan. I mean, let's be fair, most shit is not going to be friendly. By any stretch of the imagination. You'd think I could just go over to, like, the grass or whatever and just take some plant fiber that way. Well, more insects, that's good. Okay, how many... I'm paranoid that while I'm in this screen... Ooh, yeah, I need, what, 18 twine? I can craft 8. I'll craft 8 twine, how about that? Motherfucker, what was that? Motherfuckers over there about to kill each other, or... Ah. I'm gonna mind my business over here. You guys do what you need to do over there. None of my business if you guys are trying to kill each other. Ooh, plant fiber. That's what we need. And seeds. We're gonna collect this. I kinda want something in the way of weapons before... Yeah, I go see what's going on over there. Oh, fuck you. Fuck you. Back. Hey, back. Hold E for more options. Oh, sure, I'll loot all. I'm sorry, was that an option to open? Oh, okay. I mean, like, am I gonna fucking, like, you know, dissect this fucker? Pull out some internal organs or something? Again, this is Conan. I need to... I shouldn't let that potentially surprise me. Okay, we have how many now? Where's my twine? 9 twine. We need 9 more twine. And we can make 8. Okay. Let's see about... Oh, and that's why I needed more twine. Oh, fuck you. Really? You mutant-ass son of a... Bitch. Die. 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 Holy shit. Okay. Where's that other body? I didn't know I could do that. I can eat these fuckers? Where did I leave that dude's corpse? Did it disappear already? I mean, I know I shouldn't be quite this excited about the fact that I can apparently hack up the dead bodies of my enemies, but... Still, it's kind of cool. Alright, where are my... I'm not going to eat that raw. I have insects. I'm going to eat the insects. Gets as much food back as I can. Okay, I mean, that doesn't give me much, but it's useful for now. Okay. Can I finally... I can craft my sword, which I shall do right now. I can craft a shield, which I shall also do right now. I craft a bedroll. Need 6 plant fiber. Alright, where's another one of those? No. You seem like a very bulked up, angry turtle thing. I shall leave you be. collect a bit more plant fiber this way. Dude! What do you want? Oh, fuck. You fucking... Oh my god, that is... That is brutal. Oh shit. And did I just fuck it? Eugh. Okay. Wasn't expecting that shit now. Okay, who's creeping up on me now? Alright, level up. Something is walking way too close to me right now. Oh, it's that big angry turtle thing. I don't know why I keep hitting that button. Okay. Let's level up real quick. Let's do vitality. And I know I'm jumping all over the place with my abilities here, but... You know. I feel like that's kind of the way to go for now. Okay, we're gonna go with that. Holy... What the f- I might die there. Nope. I thought I was gonna die there. Okay, we're gonna back the fuck up out of here. Go back up on the ridge. And get out of that little danger zone. Man, I was not trying to pick a fight with fucking anybody. Are they just assuming? Okay, no, there's human flesh. Okay. I was gonna say, they just kind of assuming I'm gonna go... You know, I'm gonna go, cannibal? How do I heal? Is there any way to heal? Like, where's... It's like they're a first aid thing? Be nice. I think I should really learn Torch. Because I don't have the... I need two to learn Archery. I think a Torch is a good one, too. Okay. Well, I need access to a water source first. What's it take to make a campfire? 50 branches and... Okay. Oh, my health comes back automatically. Okay. Is it really? Can I just eat this? I mean, it's consumable. And I'm food poisoned. Well, if I'm already food poisoned... Oh, boy. You know what? I think I'm gonna go steal your fucking camp. No, that's... You got a big ass... You got one of those assholes right next to you. I need a water source, too. So I'm gonna go around all you assholes. Try to find a place to set up my own camp. Because all you motherfuckers can go to hell. Can I just swim to that? You fuck off. Apparently I'm underwater the entire time I'm in the water. Like my head's just all the way under no matter what. Thirsty. Can I... Oh. That's a good thing right there. I can fill it up by just aiming at that and selecting my water skin. Okay. This might be a good place to potentially set up a temporary camp. While we learn the ins and outs of this game. And we need some branches. So, should probably cut down some trees. Can I just turn some of the wood I've got into branches? It'd be nice. my hatchet. Make another one. Make another hatchet. And am I anywhere being able to make that? Nope. Be nice if I could turn wood into just fucking branches. I mean, I don't have a recipe for that, do I? I need another sword soon. Okay. Didn't I just tell you to craft a hatchet? Oh, yeah, I did. Not enough space in inventory. Okay. What can I do with that? Oh, shit. I can repair it? Well, shit, I wish I'd known that. Alright, well, we're gonna cut down a bunch of these trees. We need to get as many... I know I'm not getting many branches out of this, but... I need to get as many as I can. I cannot... I'm carrying too much, I cannot move. At all? Holy shit. That's worse than, like, Skyrim shit. Drop? God fucking... Yep, that thing just damn... like, full-on just ate me. Yep. Yeah, I should have done that. Where are you gonna start me? Yes, I know I was killed by a crocodile. That island should not be too hard for me to find, though. Oof. But I don't think I'm anywhere near where I spawned the last time. Shit. Shit, if there's not enemies everywhere. Okay, we're gonna back out to the desert over here. And, yep, looking at the time, it does look like I am out of time for today. So thank you everybody for watching and checking out Conan Exiles with me. And if you enjoyed the video at all, then please, by all means, feel free to like, comment, subscribe, or any combination of those actions that suits you today. And with that being said, I'll see you next time.